Right guys, so here's the two nail guns sitting side by side. This is the newest version. This is the DCN930. And this is the older version, which is the DCN692 Type 3. Purchased this newer version because it does have some different features. So there are a few differences with these guns. Basically on the old version of the nail gun, something I didn't like was to load the nails. You've got to pull this clip right down to the bottom, then it jams. Then you can put your strip of nails in and then you press this to get it up. I mean, it works perfectly well, but because I'm so used to using Pazload nail guns, it's just a different way of doing it. Yeah, so on the new nail gun, it's more like a Pazload way of loading the nails. Whereas you don't need to move this, you can just put the nails in. Just depress this little button here, slide this down, and that's your nails engaged. And then to disengage, just press that button again, it slides up, the nails fall out. The next difference with the nail gun is on the old one, you had like a 1 and 2 set in here, so number 1 and then number 2. What I used to always use that for was like, on the number 1 set, and if I was using 50mm nails or shorter nails, I would leave it on number 1. Number 2 is more if you're using 90mm nails. It just gives you more power. And then you've got your single shot and your bump fire mode there. But on the new nail gun, so here's the new one. It's only got one setting, power setting. And the only switch on this nail gun is single fire mode and bump fire mode. So you don't need to worry about setting 1 or setting 2. This is obviously just on full power all the time, which is better in my opinion. The next difference is your belt clip or your rafter hook. So this is the old nail gun. It's got a plastic rafter hook. Slides out. Put it in any sort of position. It's quite bulky that, but on the new nail gun, you can see the rafter hook there. It's more like Pazload as well. So I think one thing to mention is that the new nail gun is quite a bit lighter than the old nail gun. Don't quote me, but I think it's around about 3.5 kilograms, whereas this one is 4.1 kilograms. I think that's basically down to, there's a few weight saving issues on here, which you can see, not issues, but weight saving, you know, design features on here, which probably is the magazine. It's quite a lot less material. It seems to be, you know, cut out if you look at this compared to this. But the one big thing is this is like a cast construction on the old nail gun. So this is metal. The new one is some sort of composite plastic. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. So there's that magazine, slightly different design. These sort of end caps are different. The Allen key on this one, you know, if you ever need to, you know, release this if you get a jam, is a lot more accessible. It's sort of, you can see it on the back of the magazine there. A lot easier to get at, whereas the old one, you know, it's hard to even see, but it's tucked in behind there. And sometimes that could be a bit of a pain to get out, a bit fiddly to get out. Apart from that, they're pretty much the same. The depth gauge for your nails is pretty much the same design. That's the new one. That's the old one. Same design. Jam release is pretty much the same. That's your quick release on your old gun. There's your new gun. The nose cones, pretty much identical. So I guess those are all design features that I've went through. There are design differences. I think the main upgrade to this new gun is what I'll show now. Right, so the main difference for me, I'll just demonstrate now. This is the old nail gun, so I'll just fire a couple of nails and just show you. Just on single shot, so to operate this one, you just depress the nose. You'll hear the flywheel spin up, so I'll do that. So hopefully you can hear the flywheel. So every time you depress the nose cone, that flywheel will spin up. So we'll fire a nail now. As soon as you fire it, the flywheel sort of runs down. So with this one, you get a sense that when you fire a nail, you get a sense that you have to sort of wait, you know, half a second or so before you could fire the next nail. Whereas that's where the new one differs. So when you come off, you can still hear the flywheel going. It goes, I'll wait till that stops. Basically with this one, the flywheel just is continuous. So, which means you can just fire nails a lot faster. You can hear the flywheel still going. Here's the old one again. So, it's maybe hard to tell, but you do get the impression that you have to wait just that millisecond before you fire the second nail, and then the third nail, and so on. Okay, so we'll do 90mm nails now. This is the old gun. We'll do three nails with this, and then three nails with the new one. So, this is the old gun. No problem at all. Here's the new gun. No problem. So you can see there, nails, 90mm nails buried, no problem at all. So in conclusion guys, personally, if it was me, I would go for the DCN, I've forgotten the number, 930, sorry. So personally I would go for the newer version over the older version, just purely on the basis that it's slightly lighter, and to me it seems a bit more powerful. And also, you know, it's faster because of the flywheels constantly spinning. So, and the magazine, you know, it's not a big thing, but it's just what I'm used to. I like that design as opposed to the design of this one. But if you're on a budget and you're in the market for a first fix, you know, cordless nail gun, there's nothing wrong with this at all. This is a DCN 692. The other thing to mention is the price. So, as I said, if you're on a budget, this is the best one to go for. It's slightly cheaper than this one. I paid roughly £400 for the bare tool for this one. And I think now you can pick these up for round about just under £300. So, it's 25% cheaper than this one. So, guys, if you're in the market for any of these guns, hopefully this video was of some use. Just showed you some of the slight differences and, you know, between the two variants. As I've said, I would probably recommend this one. So, if you found the video helpful, and anyway guys, please give the video a thumbs up as usual, and if you're new to the channel and enjoy this sort of content, please subscribe, it would be hugely appreciated. And we'll hopefully see you in the next one guys, so thanks again, see you later, bye.